Hi, I'm Matt Parker, and these are my top five favorite maths blunders. First up, number two. In 1983, Air Canada Flight 143 was taking off from Edmonton to fly to Montreal, and they calculated how much fuel the Boeing 767 would require for that flight. But they calculated it in kilograms, and then they fueled it using pounds. The problem is, a pound is less than half a kilogram. So the aircraft had about half as much fuel as it required. Amazingly, they had to stop in Ottawa partway through the flight. There the fuel would be checked and it could be refueled. Although, sadly, they made exactly the same unit conversion mistake and the aircraft took off again without adding extra fuel. Sure enough, it ran out mid-air and the pilot, who thankfully used to be a glider pilot, had to fly a Boeing 767 with no power and glide it to a nearby disused runway. Amazingly, no one died. Number four. Spreadsheets. The European Spreadsheet Risk Interest Group, which is a real organization, I'm a big fan of their work, they have calculated that 24% of all spreadsheets which have some kind of calculation in them have a mathematical error. But how wrong can a spreadsheet go? Well, in 2012, JP Morgan Chase lost a decent amount of money because of a series of spreadsheet blunders. It's difficult to put an exact amount of money on it because they're obviously a bit cagey about the whole thing, but estimates seem to be around $6 billion lost because of poor spreadsheet use. One mistake was someone accidentally summed two cells instead of taking their average. A simple mistake and billions of dollars gone. Number three, the street signs in the UK for a football stadium are geometrically incorrect. The classic football is made of hexagons and pentagons. The dark patches are pentagons, five sides. But on a street sign, the symbol for a stadium is a football with dark patches that are hexagons, six sides. They're not hexagons, they're pentagons. And not only is the sign wrong, it's actually impossible, the worst type of wrong. It is mathematically impossible to make a closed ball shape entirely out of hexagons. We can prove that you cannot do that. So the street signs in the UK for a football stadium simply cannot work. And you know, I have petitioned the government to change it. 20,000 people signed my petition, and so far they have refused. The government in the UK doesn't think that street signs need to be geometrically plausible. Number one, in 1995, Pepsi ran a promotion where you could buy their products, collect Pepsi points, and then trade them in for things like t-shirts, leather jackets, sunglasses, stuff you needed in 1995. And in their commercial, they hilariously showed a Harrier 2 jump jet and said that for 7 million Pepsi points, you could get the jet. It was intended to be a joke until people noticed that you could buy Pepsi points for 10 cents each. This would only cost you $700,000 plus $10 shipping and handling. But who is going to get that kind of money together? Someone called John Leonard. He actually got the money together, put it in an account, applied for the jet. Pepsi said no, his lawyers said yes. It went to court and Pepsi won. It turns out it was a joke. They had to change the ad to be 700 million points instead. But why? I have no idea why they didn't just start with that. They just picked 7 million and didn't check if that was big enough. And finally, mass blunder number zero. The series of civilization computer games where you have your own civilization and compete against famous world leaders from the present and history has been incredibly popular. It sold over 33 million copies. But when the first version came out in 1991, people noticed that Gandhi, instead of being peace-loving, kept dropping nuclear weapons on other civilizations. Why was Gandhi so aggressive? It turns out, in the code, when they were programming the game, they initially set Gandhi's aggressiveness rating to be 1. But then, when civilizations gradually became more civilized, they reduced all the leaders' aggressions ratings by 2. So Gandhi went down to 0, and then, well, in computer memory, you don't go down to negative numbers, you roll around to the maximum possible value. Suddenly Gandhi was as aggressive as he could be. And ever since that first version of the game, they have left that in as a tribute to the original programming mistake. There is a whole generation of people who grew up playing these games who associate Gandhi with unnecessary nuclear strikes. So what can you learn from these incredible maths blunders? Well, for a start, people get maths wrong all the time. Maths is difficult. Humans are just not good at doing mathematics. So don't take it personally. Even mathematicians struggle. A mathematician is not someone who finds maths easy. It's someone who enjoys how difficult it is. And thank goodness there are people out there working away at mathematics, trying to get it correct, and they put together the maths and the technology which underpins our modern society and keeps us all safe.